Welcome back to School of Civil Engineering. This is Hedaetullah with another new video. In our previous two videos, I have shown you that how we'll find out column detailing and beam detailing. In this video, I'm going to show that how we'll find out our slab detailing. So to find out that, just come here, design, then click slab design. After that, check that your slab is okay or not, and if your slab is not okay, you can see our previous video already have discussed about that how we'll pass our fail slab. So after that, when it is okay, now we'll just go here drawing. Okay, so we'll go here for drawing, and from here I will just go here second floor, as in second floor we have, so just click here in second floor, just there no load. So in our second floor there have, and if I just go here slab design, I'll just see that. So in second floor we'll find out our slab detailing. Okay, so from here is the detailing for slab and mat. So just I will click here, and from here I will select our 1 inch equal to 1 feet. Okay, so it's slab and mat. From here and from here, layout layer configuration. Okay, for this is for wall, top reinforcement, bottom reinforcement, this is for punching, and drawing for wall. We'll find out for wall, I mean wall reinforcement. Then just press OK and wait for that. And if you're new to our channel, and if you're new first time come to our channel, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel. After that, if I zoom that, so this is a slab thickness 5 1 1 by 2, I mean 5 plus 1 by 2 means 5.5 inch or slab. And this is for bottom. Okay, this is for bottom in that direction, this is for bottom reinforcement in that direction, and its spacing is number 3 bar. We'll use number 3 bar, and in spacing of 9. Okay, in spacing of 9 inch 27 by 32, 9 inch plus 27 by 32. This is our x direction, y direction reinforcement, and this is for x directional reinforcement. This is for bottom. Okay, and if we go here, this is for top, this is for top, and this is for bottom. Okay, so if we come here, here also same here, so here there have some difference. In here it was 9 feet, and there have some difference in that panel. It's number 3 for top, number 3 bar, and it's 7. Okay, 7 inch plus 7 by 8, almost 8 inch. So here in that direction, I mean in x direction, it's number 3 bar, and it's 6 plus 57 by 64 inch. So in that way you can find out your reinforcement, and here is the reinforcement also. Okay, I'll just recommend you, I'll just tell you that use the reinforcement number 3 reinforcement is 6 inch to 7 inch. Okay, center to center, it is better to use. And also you can use that, it will be economical very, but for proper safety you can use that. It will give your building, it give a strength, various good strength. And here is the reinforcement detailing, so like that you can find out that. And here you can see that total amount required, I mean total 1.669 tons still are required for that floor. Okay, for that floor, this is the requirement of our steel. Now, suppose here you can see that this is the scale factor. Okay, this is a slab or mat layout. So just if you go to our, if you close that, after that, if you select that and right click, okay, select that, right click, and go to in 3D, then just select that, then right click, okay, and from here just you can click here, check design plan, report for that member and design member. So I'll click report for that member. So here is the report for that member. Here is the report, and here total area provided 0.13 inch square per feet, and for area required 0.06 inch square. Okay, and this is for bottom and this is for top. This is for bottom and this is for top. So, and here is the utilization. This is the utilization. Okay, I mean how percent we have, I mean how much we have this utilization provide in one. Okay, so here is the utilization, and sometime if you want to use that, I will use utilization, I will change that utilization, then you can also change that, but it will be very risky. So from, I mean like that, you can also see that. So just close here, after that escape, and from here also, okay, you can also see the slab reinforcement. Use property here, use property grid to review and edit or dimensionless panel and patch reinforcement. Just click here, okay, and just see here the reinforcement. Okay, this is the reinforcement in different directions. So if I go here and click here, see the reinforcement here, the reinforcement. Okay, reinforcement size, and this is the spacing, and this is the provided reinforcement per inch square. Okay, so just apply. You can go here, user bar, also you can use the user bar. Just wait for some time. So from here you can give the bar size and bar spacing. You can give the bar spacing. Okay, suppose if you give the bar spacing 6, then click here, slab reinforcement. This is the reinforcement in x direction, sorry, here for x direction, and also you can see the reinforcement for y direction also. Just see that this is bar for y direction, and suppose I'll just come here. Now suppose you need to change that reinforcement. Okay, I mean if you you need to change its spacing or anything, and you need to give you need that reinforcement spacing according to your requirement. So I will give the spacing, how number bar you will use. If you need to know about that, just give me the comment, give me a comment in below. So I'll try to change that, and I will also try to modify that. So thank you very much, and if you think that's helpful for you, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And in our next video, I will show that how we'll design our foundation, and also how we'll find out reinforcement detailing from our foundation. So if you are a civil engineer, and if you think that is helpful for you, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and also like our video, share our video, and also leave a comment. So your own like and own comment inspire us for the next work. So thank you very much. Still stay connected till next video.